Today my topic is physiology, and physiology is a wide term. Immune physiology contains many systems. The function of unit of the body is cell, and a group of similar cells constitutes a tissue. A group of tissues form a system. Recently, application of electron microscope and microhistochemical techniques have revealed quite a complex structure of the cell. The function of the body are based on experimental results and clinical findings. In order to understand the functions of the body, it is convenient to divide them broadly into the following systems. Number one, hematopoietic system, reticuloendothelial system and lymphatic system, skeletal and muscular system, circulatory system, respiratory system, digestive system and metabolism, excretory system, endocrine and reproductive system, nervous system, especially and special senses. Here I want to discuss digestive system and metabolism. But before the metabolic system, we should know the cell. What is cell? Cells are the microscopic fundamental units of the living things. Every living thing has cells, bacteria, protozoa, fungi, plants and animals are the main group kingdom of living things. Some organisms are made up of just one cell as bacteria and protozoa, but animals including human beings are multicellular. In adult, human body is composed of about 1 crore 10 lakhs cells. Each cell has basic requirements to sustain it, and the body's organic systems are largely built around providing the many trillions of the cells with those the basic needs such as oxygen, food and waste removal. There are about 22,000 different kinds of specialized cells in human body. One many trillions of the cells, those basic needs. Identical cells are organized together. It is called a tissue. Various tissues organized together to form a common purpose are called organs. As the stomach is an organ, and so it is the skin, the brain and the uterus. Ideas about the cell structure have changed considerably over the year. Early biologists saw cells as simple membranous sacs contain fluid and a few floating particles. Today's biologists knows that cells are inconceivably more complex than this. Therefore, a strong knowledge of various cellular organelles and their functions is important to any physiologist. If a person's cells are healthy, then that person is healthy. All physiological processes, diseases, growth and development can be described at the cellular level. Specialized cells of the human body. We can say it, although there are specialized cells both in structure and functions within the body, all cells have similarities in their structural organization and metabolic needs, such as maintaining energy level via conversion of carbohydrate to ATP and using genes to maintain protein. And here are some of the different types of specialized cells within the human body. Number one, nerve cells. also called neurons. These cells are in the nervous system and function to process the transmit information. It is hypothesized they are the core component of the brain, spinal cord, peripheral nerves. They use chemical synapses that can evoke electrical signals called action potentials to relay signals throughout the body. Epithelial cells are the functions of epithelial cells, including secretion, absorption, protection, transcellular transport, sensation detection, and selective permeability. Epithelium linings, both the outside skin and inside cavities and of lumen of bodies. Exocrine cells, these cells secrete products through ducts such as mucus, sweat, or digestive enzymes. The products of these cells go directly to the target organ through the ducts. For example, bile from gallbladder is carried directly into the duodenum via bile duct. Endocrine cells, these cells are similarly to exocrine cells but secrete their products directly into the bloodstream instead of through a duct. Endocrine cells are found throughout the body but are concentrated in hormone secreting glands such as the pituitary. The product of endocrine cells go throughout body in the bloodstream but act on a specific organ by receptors on the cells of the target organs. For example, the hormone estrogen acts especially on the uterus and breast of the female because there are estrogen receptors in the cells of the target organs. Blood cells. The most common type of blood cells are red blood cells, which can be pronounced or called erythrocytes. The main function of the red blood cells is to collect oxygen in the lungs and deliver it through blood to the body tissue. Gas exchange is carried by simple diffusion to various spots. Various type of white blood cells. White blood cells, also known as leukocytes, they are produced in the bone marrow and help the body to fight infectious diseases and foreign objects in immune system. While cells are found in the circulatory system, lymphatic system, spleen, and other body tissues. Cell size. Cells are smallest in living units within our body, but play a big role in making our body functions properly. Many cells never have a large increase in size after they are the first formed from a parental cell. Typical stem cells reproduce double in size, then reproduce again. Most cytosolic contents such as the endomembrane system and the cytoplasm easily scale to larger size in larger cells. If a cell becomes too large, the normal cellular amount of DNA may not be adequate to keep the cell supplied with RNA. Large cells often replicate their chromosomes to an abnormally high amount or become multinucleated. Large cells that are primarily for nutrient storage can have a smooth surface membrane, but metabolically active large cells often have some sort of folding of the cells' surface membranes in order to increase the surface area available for transport functions. सेलुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, सेवरल डिफरेंट मॉलिकुलर मॉलिक्यूल्स इंटरैक्ट्स टू फॉर्म ऑर्गेनेल्स विद आवर बॉडी. ईच टाइप ऑफ ऑर्गेनेल हैज स्पेसिफिक फंक्शन. ऑर्गेनेल्स परफॉर्म द वाइटल फंक्शंस दैट कीप आवर सेल अलाइव. सेल मेम्ब्रेन्स, द बाउंड्री ऑफ सेल sometimes called the plasma membrane separates internal metabolic event from external environment and control the movement of materials into and out of the cell. The cell membrane is very selective about what is allowed to pass through. This characteristic is referred to as selective permeability. For example, it allow oxygen and nutrients to enter the cell while keeping toxins and waste products out. The plasma membrane is a double phospholipid membrane or a lipid bilayer with the non-polar hydrophobic tails pointing toward the inside of the membrane, and the polar hydrophilic heads form the inner and outer surface of the membrane. Protein and cholesterol. Protein and cholesterol molecules are scattered throughout the flexible phospholipid membranes. Peripheral proteins attach closely to the inner outsider surface of the plasma membrane. Integral proteins lie across the membrane, extending from inside to outside. A variety of proteins are scattered throughout the flexible matrix of phospholipid molecules, somewhat like iceberg floating in the ocean, and this is termed the fluid mosaic model of the cell membrane. The phospholipid bilayer is selectively permeable. Only small unchanged polar molecules can pass freely across the membrane. Some of these molecules are H2O, hydrogen, and CO2, carbon dioxide. Hydrophobic non-polar molecules like oxygen, O2, and lipid-soluble molecules such as hydrocarbons. Other molecules need the help of a membrane protein to get across. There are a variety of membrane proteins that serve various functions. Channel proteins. These proteins that provide passageways through the membranes for certain hydrophilic or water-soluble substances such as polar and charged molecules. No energy is used during transport, hence this type of movement is called facilitated diffuse. Transport proteins. Proteins that spend energy, ATP, to transfer material across the membrane. When energy is used to provide passageway to material, the process is called active transport. Recognition proteins. Proteins that distinguish the identity of neighboring cells. These proteins have oligosaccharide or short polysaccharide chains extending out from their cell surface. Adhesion proteins. Proteins that attach cell to neighboring cells or provide another for the internal filaments and tubules that give stability to the cell. Receptor proteins. These proteins that initiate a specific cell response. Once hormones or other trigger molecules bind to them. Electron transfer proteins. Electron transfer proteins are that are involved in moving electron from one molecule to another during chemical reactions. Passive transport across the cell membrane. पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट मीन्स डिस्क्राइब द मूवमेंट ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस डाउन ए कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट एंड डज नॉट रिक्वायर एनर्जी यूज. बल्क फ्लो इज द कलेक्टिव मूवमेंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस इन सेम डायरेक्शंस इन रेस्पॉन्स टू इट्स फोर्स सच एज प्रेशर. ब्लड मूविंग थ्रू ए वेसल इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ बल्क फ्लो. सिंपल डिफ्यूजन और डिफ्यूजन इज द नेट मूवमेंट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेज फ्रॉम एन एरिया ऑफ हायर कंसंट्रेशन टू एन एरिया ऑफ लोअर कंसंट्रेशन. दिस मूवमेंट अकर्स एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ द रेंडम एंड कॉन्स्टेंट मोशन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ ऑल मॉलिक्यूल्स एटम्स और आयन्स एंड इट इंडिपेंडेंट फ्रॉम द मोशन ऑफ अदर द मॉलिक्यूल्स. सिंस at any one time some molecules may be moving against the gradient and some molecules may be moving down the gradients, although the motion is random. The word net is used to indicate the overall eventual and result of the movement. Facilitated diffusion is diffusion of solutes through channel proteins in the plasma membrane. Water can pass freely through the plasma membrane without aid of specialized protein through facilitated by aquaporins. Osmosis is the diffusion of water molecules across the selective permeable membranes. Osmosis is the diffusion of water molecules across selective permeable membranes. One, water moves into a body by osmosis. Hydrostatic pressure or osmotic pressure may build up inside the body. Dialysis is the diffusion of solutes across selective permeability membrane. Active transport across the cell membrane. Active transport is the movement of solute against a gradient and requires the expenditure of energy, usually in the form of ATP. Active transport is achieved through one of these two mechanisms. Protein pumps. Transport protein is the plasma membrane transfer solutes such as small ions, sodium ion, potassium ion, chloride ion, hydrogen ion, amino acids and monosaccharides. The proteins involved with the active transports are also known as ion pump. The protein binds to a molecule of the substance to be transported on one side of the membrane. Then it uses the released energy ATP to change its shape and releases it on the other side. The protein pumps are specific. There is a different pump for each molecule to be transported. Protein pumps are catalyst in the splitting of ATP to ADP plus phosphate. So they are called ATPase enzymes. The sodium potassium pump, also called the sodium potassium ion ATPase enzyme, actively moves sodium out of the cell and potassium into the cell. These pumps are found in the membrane of virtually every cell and are essential in transmission of nerve impulse and in muscular contractions. Cystic fibrosis is a genetic disorder that results in a mutated chloride ion channel. By not regulating chloride secretion properly, water flow across the airway surface is reduced and mucus becomes dehydrated and thick. Vesicular transport. Vesicles or other bodies in the cytoplasm move macromolecules or large particles across the plasma membrane. Types of vesicular transport included: number one, exocytosis, which describe the process of vesicles fusing with the plasma membrane and releasing their contents to the outside of the cell. This process is common when a cell produces substances for export. Number two, endocytosis, which describes the capture of substance outside the cell when the plasma membrane merges to engulf it. The substance subsequently enters the cytoplasm enclosed in a vesicle. There are three kinds of endocytosis. Number one, phagocytosis or cellular eating occurs when the dissolved materials enter the cell. The plasma membrane engulfs the solid materials, forming a phagocytic vesicle. Number two, pinocytosis or cellular drinking occurs when the plasma membrane folds inward to form a channel allowing the dissolved substances to enter the cell. When the channel is closed, the liquid is encircled within a pinocytic vesicle. Receptor-mediated endocytosis occurs when specific molecules in the fluid surrounding the cell bind to plasma membrane. As a pinocytosis, the plasma membrane folds inward and the formation of a vesicle follows. Now we discuss organelles. Organelles are bodies embedded in the cytoplasm that serve to physically separate the various metabolic activities that occur within the cell. The organelles are each like separate little factories. Each organelle is responsible for producing a certain product that is used elsewhere in the cell or body. Cell of all living things are divided into two broad categories, prokaryotes and eukaryotes. The bacteria and archaea are prokaryotes, which means they lack of a nucleus or other membranes bound organelles. Eukaryotes include all protozoans, fungi, plants and animals, including human, and these cells are characterized by nucleus which houses the chromosomes as well as varieties of other organelles. Human cells vary considerably. Consider the difference between a bone cell, a blood cell, a nerve cell, but most cells have features described below. Number one, nucleus. Control of the cell houses the genetic material, DNA. The nucleus is the largest of the cell's organelle. Cells can have more than one molecule or lack a nucleus altogether. Skeletal muscle cells contains more than one nucleus, whereas red blood cells do not contain a nucleus at all. The nucleus is bounded by the nuclear envelope, a phospholipid bilayer similar to the plasma membrane. The space between these two layers is the nucleolemma cisterna. The nucleus contains the DNA, as the mentioned above. Hereditary information in the cells. Normally, the DNA is spread out within the nucleus as a thread-like matrix called chromatin. When the cell membranes to divide, the chromatin condenses into rod-shaped bodies called chromosomes, each of which before dividing is made up of two long DNA molecules and various histone molecules. The histone serve to organize the lengthy DNA, coiling it into bundle called nucleosomes. Also visible within the nucleus are one or more nuclei, each consisting of DNA in process of manufacturing, and the components of ribosomes. Ribosomes are shipped to cytoplasm, where they assemble amino acid into proteins. The nucleus also serves as the site for separation of chromosomes during cell division. Mitochondria. Mitochondria are the organelles that functions as the cell powerhouse, generating ATP, universal form of energy used by all cells. It converts food nutrients such as glucose to a fuel ATP that the cells of the body can use. Mitochondria are tiny sac-like structures found near the nucleus. Little shelves called cristae are formed from folds in the inner membranes. Cells that are the metabolically active, such as muscles, liver, and kidney cells, have high energy requirements, therefore have more mitochondria. Mitochondria are unique in that they have their own mitochondrial DNA separate from the DNA that is in the nucleus. It is believed that eukaryotes evolved from one cell living inside another cell, and mitochondria share many traits with free living bacteria. Similarly, chromosomes, similar ribosomes, etc. Next is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic means within the plasma, and reticulum means network. A complex three-dimensional internal membrane of the system, flattened sheets, sacs, tubes that play an important role in making proteins and shuttling cellular products. Also involved in the metabolism of fat and the production of various materials in a cross section, they appear as a series of maze-like channel, often closely associated with nucleus. When ribosomes are present, the rough ER-attached polysaccharide groups to polypeptides. As they are assembled by the ribosomes, a smooth ER without ribosomes is responsible for various activities, including the synthesis of lipids and hormones, especially in cells that produce these substances for export from the cells. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has characteristic bumpy appearance due to the multitude of ribosomes coating it. It is the site where proteins destined for cytoplasm are synthesized. A smooth endoplasmic reticulum provides a variety of functions, including lipid synthesis, degradation, and calcium ion storage. In liver cells, the smooth ER is involved in the breakdown of toxins, drugs, and toxic byproducts from cellular reactions. Next is Golgi apparatus. Cellular products in sac called vesicles, so that products can cross the cell membrane and exit the cell. Golgi apparatus is the central delivery system for cell. It is a group of flattened sacs arranged much like a stack of bowl. The function to modify the package proteins and lipids into vesicles, a small spherically shaped sacs that bud from end of a Golgi apparatus. Vesicles often migrate to and merge with the plasma membrane, releasing their contents outside the cells. The Golgi apparatus also transport lipid and creates lysosomes and organelles involved in digestion. Vacuoles are the space in cytoplasm that sometimes serve to carry material to the cell membrane for discharge to outside the cell. Vacuoles are formed during endocytosis when portion of the cell membrane are pinched off. Lysosomes are sac-like compartments that contain a number of powerful degradative enzymes. They are built in the Golgi apparatus. They break down harmful cells products and waste materials, cellular debris, and foreign invaders such as bacteria, and then force them out of the cell. Now, cell metabolism is the total energy released and consumed by a cell. Metabolism describes all the chemical reactions that are happening in the body. Some reactions called anabolic reactions create needed products. Other reactions called catabolic reactions break down product. Your body is performing both anabolic and catabolic reactions at the same time and around the clock. 24 hours a day to keep your body alive and functioning. Even while you sleep, your cells are busy metabolizing. Catabolism, the energy releasing process in which a chemical or food is used, broken down by degradation or decomposition into smaller pieces. And anabolism is a process. Anabolism is just the opposite of catabolism. In this portion of metabolism, the cell consumes energy to produce larger molecules via smaller ones. Energy-rich molecules, adenosine triphosphate, ATP. Now we can discuss the metabolism. First of all, what is metabolism? In definition form, the sum of process in the buildup and destruction of protoplasm, specifically the chemical changes in living cells by which energy is provided for vital processes, activities, new materials assimilated. Provided for vital processes and activities and new materials assimilated method. Anabolism or catabolism, the sum of the process by which in the particular substances is handled as by assimilation and incorporation, by detoxification and excretion in the living body. The complex of physical and chemical processes occurring within the living cells or organisms that are necessary for the maintenance of life. In metabolism, some substances are broken down to yield energy for vital processes, while other substances necessary for life are synthesized. The function of a specific substance, such as water, within the living body. The chemical processes by which cell produce the substances and energy needed to sustain life as part of metabolism. Organic compounds are break down to provide an energy in the process called catabolism. Similar, the molecules are also used to build more complex compounds like proteins for growth and repair of tissue as the part of anabolism. Many metabolic processes are brought about the action of enzymes. The overall speed at which an organism carries out its metabolic processes is termed its metabolic rate, or when the organism is at rest, its basal. The basal metabolic rate, birds for example have a high metabolic rate since they are warm blooded, and their usual method for the locomotion, flight, requires large amount of an energy. Accordingly, birds usually need large amount of high quality energy foods such as seeds or meat, which they must eat frequently. See more at cellular respiration. Metabolism. The different food materials, mostly complex and unsuitable for absorption, are transformed into their simple and soluble form by digestion prior to entry from the lumen of the intestine into the body through its gateway absorption. After their entry into the body, they undergo a series of biochemical reactions of different organs catalyzed by enzyme, coenzyme, catalyst, and governed by the hormones and vitamins to serve the following purposes. Substances into the types of characteristic protoplasm of different varieties of cells and tissues forming up the organism, resulting development, growth, and maintenance of a living organism. These reactions, which are included in the process of synthesis of large protoplasmic molecules from lower ones for build-up tissue, are collectively known as synthesis or anabolism. Production of energy required for the protoplasmic movement, generation of electrical potentials, the secretion and excretion reaction, which are included in the process of breakdown of large protoplasmic molecules to smaller ones for the supply of energy, are collectively called analysis or catabolism. So, definition of metabolism. Metabolism of a food substance is meant by a series of specific chemical reactions occurring within the living organisms to form from the time of its incorporation into the cell or tissue till its excretion, of which some are concerned with tissue synthesis and others with tissue breakdown. What are termed as anabolism and catabolism respectively, although both anabolism and catabolism are reversible biochemical reactions, but growth and loss of tissue mass, breakdown of tissue depends upon the predominance of one over the other opposite reactions. We can say this equation, small molecules then make growth and produce large molecules, and inversely proportional, large molecules break down loss of tissue mass and convert into small molecules. This is the irreversible, this is reversible chemical reaction of molecules. Method of metabolic study. The chemical reaction of the tissue is so numerous that the fast that the study of these reactions, either the individual or overall pictures of these reactions, had been encountered with much difficulty due to lack of suitable equipment and methods in the past, but recent advancement in the researches in the field of development of different techniques and methods at modern times, it has been possible today to unfolding the total picture of the metabolism. The general principle of the different methods of employed in the study of metabolism are as study of metabolic processes, study of metabolic arresting few metabolic steps with the certain metabolic poisons, the study of metabolism under the influence of endocrines, the study of different organs in determine of the site of the reactions. Number 5, feeding experiments, biochemical changes, study of basal metabolic rate, respiratory quotients, application of isotopes. Energy metabolism. Now we can describe what is energy metabolism. There are a continual exchange of energy between a living organism and its environment, as in accordance with the principle of thermodynamic applied to non-living physical and chemical systems. There is a fundamental difference between the plants and animals in the way of their utilization of energy for their life process. Plants, unlike animals, can convert the energy of solar photons into the energy of chemical bonds. Carbohydrates contain energy which is released during the its breakdown and store them in their leaves, stem, fruits, etc., which serves as food for the animals. Plants are therefore interposed between the sun and all animals in the energy flow relationship in nature. It follows therefore for the energy required for our bodily activities is supplied by food, which is stored with the energy, and the original sources of energy is the sun. The body's input and output of energy. The energy that is released appears as heat. The energy of increased molecules, molecular motion, which is measured in units of calories. 1 calorie is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water at 1 degree on the Celsius scale. It means energy is that release appears as heat. The energy of increased molecule motions, which is measured in units of calorie. 1 calorie is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water at 1 degree on Celsius scale. And energies associated with most chemical reactions are several thousands calories per molecule and are reported as kilocalories. 1 kilocalories is equal to 1000 calorie. Simply we can say the unit of energy is mainly expressed as heat unit or energy equivalent of foodstuffs. The calorie, also known as small calories, standard calories, or gram calorie, this is defined as amount of heat energy which can raise the temperature of 1 gram of water from 15 to 16 degrees centigrade. The measurement of heat is known as calorimeter. The apparatus for measurement being known as calorimeter in the biological system. In physiology and medicine, the unit used is large calorie or kilocalorie, kilocalorie or calorie, which is equal to 1000 small calories. 1 kilocalorie is equal to 1000 small calories. It is defined as the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water from 15 to 16 degree centigrade. The total energy obtained from food sources are utilized as for the synthesis of different types of protoplasmic constituents characteristic of different cells and tissues as phospholipids, proteins, RNA, DNA, enzyme, coenzyme and other complex substances, etc. Next, for other operation of different organs and as a whole organism, as heat, heart, lung, gland, kidney, etc. Next, number third is for the maintenance of body temperature, for the generation of electrical potential and current versus in the central nervous system and heart, etc. Five number is for the transport of substances against the concentration gradient. Next is for the growth and maintenance. Joule versus calories. Amount of heat may be expressed as equivalent amount of energy with the joule as the unit. According to the pamphlet circulated to the Nutrient Society by Royal Society 1968, the amount of heat must be expressed in terms of energy and the relationship between the two units is 1 kilocalorie equal to 4184 or 4188.5 or 4186.8 joules or about 4.19 kilojoules. Method for the determination of energy output. Energy output can be determined by measuring the heat production of an individual over a measured amount of time. Number one, direct calorimetry. Number two, indirect calorimetry. Number three, closed circuit method. Number next, open circuit method. And now, respiratory quotient. Respiratory quotient definition. It is the ratio of the volume of oxygen production by the volume of oxygen consumed during the given time. We just express it just as carbon dioxide and oxygen consumption. It is the ratio of the volume of carbon dioxide produced, and consumption of oxygen within a given time. It should be noted that RQ is simply a ratio. It gives no idea as to absolute quantity of gaseous exchange, proportional increase or diminution of carbon dioxide produced and oxygen utilization. This is only a ratio of carbon dioxide production and utilization of oxygen, and this is not a express of consumption. What is the scale, what quantity of utilization of oxygen and production of carbon dioxide, it will keep the ratio unchanged. But any disproportionate variations will be reflected by corresponding changes in respiratory quotient. Normal respiratory quotient in a healthy adult, it is 0.85 for mixed diet. When a person take mixed diet, this ratio is 0.85. method for determination. This is done by the measuring the volume of oxygen consumed and CO2 produced during a given time with the help of Douglas bag and other similar instruments. Method of determination of respiratory quotient is that this is done by measuring the volume of oxygen consumption or consumed and carbon dioxide produced during a given time with the help of Douglas bag. This is an apparatus situated in a physiology lab and other similar instruments. Factors affecting respiratory quotient. Number one, role of diet. In case of carbohydrate diet, the respiratory quotient is unity because in carbohydrate diet, the volume of carbon dioxide produced is same as the volume of oxygen consumed. In case of carbohydrate diet, this oxygen production, oxygen consumption and carbon dioxide production will be one. This is due to the fact that in carbohydrate molecules, the amount of oxygen present is just sufficient to oxidize the hydrogen present in the same molecule. Hence, external oxygen is necessary only to convert the carbon of the molecule into carbon dioxide. So that the volume of oxygen consumed and the water of CO2 produced with the same, this is represented in the following equations. C6H12O6, C6H12O6 plus 6 molecule of oxygen are equal to 6 CO2, 6 atom of carbon dioxide plus 6 atom of hydrogen or water. So RQ is equal to respiratory quotient is equal to 6 carbon dioxide and 6 oxygen, 6 carbon dioxide and 6 molecule of oxygen is equal to 1. Now here is respiratory quotient is 1. Hence external oxygen is necessary only to convert the carbon of the molecule to so that the volume of oxygen consumption and the volume of CO2 produced will be same. This is represented in the following equations as we see C6H12O6 plus 6O2 is equal to 6CO2 plus 6H2O and respiratory quotient is 6CO2 upon 6O2 is equal to 1. Next, in case of fat, the respiratory quotient will be lowest and is about 0.7. Here, respiratory quotient is 0.1 and in case of fat, respiratory quotient is 0.7. Because fat is an oxygen poor compound, the oxygen present in it cannot fully for two purposes. First, for existing carbon and producing carbon dioxide, and secondly, for the oxidizing hydrogen giving water. Consequently, the volume of carbon dioxide produced will be less than the volume of oxygen utilized, hence RQ will be fall and will be about 0.7. This is shown in the following equation. We can see here in a equation form, carbon atom C3H5 and C18H molecule are 36 and oxygen under bracket are 3 plus 163 oxygen amount is equal to, we can write here for convenience, 114 carbon dioxide, 114 carbon dioxide plus 110 oxygen, 110 hydrogen or H2O. So respiratory quotient is equal to 114 carbon dioxide upon 163 oxygen molecules, and this is 0.7. In case of fat, the RQ will be lowest, is about 0.7, because the fat is an oxygen poor compound. The oxygen present in it cannot fully oxidize the hydrogen of the molecule, so the oxygen consumed from outside is used for two purposes. First, for oxidizing carbon and producing carbon dioxide, and secondly, for oxidizing hydrogen given H2O. Consequently, the volume of carbon dioxide produced will be less than the volume of oxygen utilized, hence RQ will be fall and will be about 0.7. This is shown in our equation. In case of protein, RQ is about 0.8. Alanine C3H7O2N. C3H7O2N is alanine plus 6 oxygen is equal to NH2 under bracket carbon monoxide plus five carbon dioxide plus 5 H2O. So respiratory quotient CO2 upon 6 O2 is equal to 0.8. In case of protein, RQ is about 0.8. 2C3H7O2 and is known as alanine plus oxygen atom 6 are equal to NH2 under root 2 carbon monoxide plus 5 atoms of carbon dioxide plus 5 atoms of H2O. So oxygen consumption is 6O2 and carbon production is 5CO2. It means that the RQ of protein is 0.8.